I will never take back words that I said, that I will always come back to you. And even in the meantime, I will always stand by the mirror on the shelf. Call you in the nighttime, call you in the daytime, canvas up to you.
Hey, what is up, guys? Topher here, bringing you another high-level Halo Wars commentary today. We're going to be playing on Exile against LoadedShotgun, Harrinate, and Crazy Legs, and they will be Andrew's RB Brute, and I will be with BHM2Legit and BH Avenue, and we too will be running Andrew's RB Brute, basically the legendary Cutter RB of 3v3. This is the first game of two. I'm uploading these two videos just because the first game, there's a lot of action from my perspective, and then the second game, it's kind of interesting for some units that are built. They're not the best videos in the world, but they are videos, and they are a little bit interesting. So here they are, and I haven't thrown anything out in a while. So we're just going to be doing the typical Anders RB Brute things. Looks like we got some lag going on in the game that I don't think lasts too long, so I'm just going to let it be. Looks like BH Avenue was possibly lagging out, but now he's back in the party in a second here. There we go. I'm the Brute this game, both the games for that matter. So I've noticed with my like 3v3 videos, even though I don't have very many of them, they're pretty much my most popular videos, by views at least. So I thought I'd give you a couple more, since you guys seem to like them, even though I don't really throw out too many. I do enjoy playing threes, like high-level threes, but it's just pretty tough to get six high-level players to either matchmake or even custom nowadays for more than two games in a row. So just kind of frustrating. When you just want to play games, whether it's for true skill or not, for people that still care about that, you just want to play. This video is from like 6 months ago, if I'm perfectly blunt with you. That's pretty much all my videos. They're anywhere from, I know Bubbles said they're old, or no, I can't remember what he called them, but they're like reruns or something, I don't know. But, you guys have never seen these videos, so, like, what has really changed in the last 6 months in this game? The answer is nothing. So, it shouldn't really matter how old the video is, as long as you guys have never seen it, which you haven't. So, this is still new to you, and super old to me. I'm just going to be doing the old standard double-base Brute Rush. I'm going to hit their Brute Chieftain. I'm going to hit that purple guy over there. The Harrinate is their Brute. So, I'm going to walk on over to there, and, I don't really know what Avenue is planning on doing. I think actually he's planning on going on to offense, I think to the UNSC, because having UNSC lead is very important in threes, because at the end of the day, whoever has more Gauss is basically the team that's going to win. So anything we can do to get our UNSC, which is 2Legit, a nice little lead, we'll be good with that, and we'll be in a nice little spot. Looks like Harrinate's doing the same build as I am, Hall 4th on the Expo. You can pretty much go Hall 4th or 5th, but you might get your Hall denied if they hit you if you go 5th, so 4th is a little bit safer. So I'm not building on my base, because my name's Zero Subset. There we go, building on the old base. Looks like Harrinate Rush Quick Citadel, their RB Crazy Legs is going for the cheese on my base, and their Brute is hitting my main, so they're pretty much trying to take me out of the game, or at least stall me a lot. So I do have a couple things on offense, but I'm going to have to stall production for a little bit to try to hit Citadel on at least my Expo, and eventually my main. So Legit's doing a nice little job of ramming a little bit of that Grunt, saving some health on my base. I'm going to drop this Hall, but Harrinate already has a Hall up in the front, but I'm just going to kill it anyways, because that's what I was going for. My base is a little under half health, almost red bar, but I do have Citadel. I'm going to throw up a Summit to try to get the Clutch Engineer out. Looks like Harrinate is aiming down my temple for no apparent reason. Don't get that one, but okay, I'll deal with it. And I'm just going to try to build a couple more Brutes. I could be building some Yackles out of that Expo to start to hit that Arbiter. That probably would have been a good idea, but I'm not doing it. Instead, I'm just going to go for Citadel on my main, because I know at some point I'm probably going to get my main down, just because he's getting units through and we're not playing defense on him, because Avenue decided to go onto offense onto that inner space. I'm pretty sure he's doing some good work to it. Too legit has our reactors cleared. He probably just killed the snipers. Is heading down. Instead of hitting the back unit C base, he's just going to go down and help Avenue. He's going to try to camp the grunts out of the Arby's base to try to save my base a little bit. My summit did get up. I'm building an engineer. So he's trying to camp the grunts out of one base, and now he's going to go help Avenue put some pressure onto that Anders base. I'm pretty sure that Anders base is pretty strict right now, even though I know I'm not looking at it, because I have a lot going on my bases and trying to still hold some stuff down on offense. So you can see here that Legit is now going to go back. We killed their Anders base, which is pretty great. And I got an engineer out. And when I get an engineer out and my base lives, Crazy Legs is just going to decide to call it a quit on that one. And they're not going to kill my Expo. And Legit has maybe 9 to 11 Goss on my base, poking off the Hall Rush on me. So I don't believe they're going to be able to kill my main either. I don't really know where their hogs were this game. I didn't see them once, I don't think. So I don't know where Loaded was. Oh, okay, there's his hogs. I guess he was clearing the reactors in a base up top or something. But yeah, that's the first time I've seen him, so I don't know what he was doing with them, really. But whatever. And I'm just holding a vortex. This game is over because Crazy Legs just decided to quit. Just because I guess he was like a little mad that he didn't kill the base. Or I don't know, he just thought it was over. Probably not even mad. But yeah, I saw a supply pad on my expo, I did lose my main. Okay, that's pretty cool. I saw a supply pad for my temple. I probably should have just dropped that hall for the temple, or I dropped the summit for the temple, but it doesn't really matter. And yeah, now we're going to move on to game two. These games were actually played in chronological order, so this was literally the game right after the previous. And it's another Anders RV Brute Mirror. Instead of the front spawn, I'm going to be the back spawn. I'm going to take the same expo, though. Legit is going to also take... We're going to take the same expos as we did the first game, with Legit taking the back base. You can take... it's better for the UNC to take the mid base, but like the second tier of the three tiers for the levels, because you can get your Marines into the reactors a little bit faster. But if you lose your UNC base and they go for an all-in cheese and actually kill your base, then you're a little screwed. So it doesn't really matter too much. The back base isn't bad by any means, but the middle base is just a little bit better. But at the end of the day, it doesn't matter all that much. So we're just going to be doing another pretty standard start. The people are just like the same. We have Harrinate as the Brute, Loaded as the UNSC, and Crazy Legs as the Arby. And the same for our team, Legit as the Anders, and BH Avenue is the Arbiter. So I didn't really catch what they were doing at all last game, and I probably won't catch what they're doing this game either, because when I play, many times, you probably know this in all my videos, is I don't really look at my other teammates. I just, unless I'm UNSC, I'm way more inclined to look at what my cubbies are doing, because you just have a little more freedom to look at around the map when you're UNSC, because when you're like cubby, you're always doing stuff with your leader and all that good stuff. So yeah, I'm just doing a Temple 5th again. And I'm just, doing things. So, haven't really been playing too much of the Halo Wars as of late. I've streamed a couple times, and that's pretty much when I've been playing. Last night, I guess, in other news, me, Metallic Monkey, and I'm Not Very Legit played some Free For All in Agario. If any of you have seen that, it's been a pretty popular web browser game of late. We were pretty much dominating for 3 hours into the wee hours of the morning. We held the one spot for quite literally 3 hours. It was a pretty good time, but that's just a interesting game that is kind of new. If you've ever played it, I recommend you give it a try. It sounds pretty dumb. I know we even played it last night when C-Mitch was also in our party with the three of us, and we were playing Agario. We had four people, two play twos customs on Halo Wars. And we're just like, nah, this is more fun. And Mitch was pretty salty. Well, not salty about it, but he didn't agree with our decision to play Agario instead of Two's Customs. But at the end of the day, we were having a good time. So, yeah, you can see down there at Purple's Expo, which is BH Avenue. Loaded Shotgun, instead of going for the Gauss build this time, he went for a change of pace and went for the Marine Rush. So he's going to be getting RPG on those bad boys relatively quickly. And going to be Marine Rushing Avenue's base. And we can't really do much about it right now. It's pretty costly to rage down those Marines. So Avenue's not going to have a good time down there if he's trying to play defense on it. Which he might be, it looks like. I'm trying to get a couple of rams off, but I mean, at the end of the day, like, I'm gonna get like two rams off, and it's not gonna do much at all. So there's the Arby. He's not gonna go for the cheese on my base this time because it didn't go so well last time. So I'm pretty much telling Avenue that I think he might try to cheese his main. So I tell Avenue to hop on that Citadel on his main, which is going up right now, but looks like instead Avenue is gonna, our Crazy Legs is just gonna grunt down the temple, which is a little bit interesting. Looks like their brute this time, instead of hitting my main, is gonna hit my expo. And Avenue is playing defense. Legit did kill the two snipers, and he's on offense with me. I'm gonna hit Citadel. I gotta play defense with these brutes and Hull that I popped out of my expo to try to buy a little bit of time so I can get Citadel finished. Here's the Marine Rush going down. They're starting to put some damage on the main. Luckily, Harrinate stayed on an outpost, so this is going to be a really quick kill. Because look, while he does have a ton of units, his base is going to die. I mean, by going Hall of Third in your expo, you are going to get a bunch of grunts out. But now his expo is just dead because it's outpost, and we have a bunch of grunt hogs, and like my chieftain and like two brutes or something. So since I have a haul up, I'm going to start building jackals and brutes out of this base and start trying to knock off some of the stuff on it. Avenue is coming back to my base because his base down there is pretty much a lost cause. So we'd rather him try to save my base just because his base is just dead. There's no point of trying to save it. So he's going to be raging with my jackals and my brood squads. I'm going to be going for a summit, probably try to get an engineer up again so Legit doesn't have to heal my base. And I got a decent amount of, I have five brutes on offense now, it looks like, and I got some more stuff back at my base. So we have this pretty much pushed off. We even have a hog in on the action here, and everything's pretty much dead. So once again, they went for like the all-in on my base. They didn't get it again on my expo, so that's really good for us. The Marine Rush by Loaded Shotgun is about to kill BH Avenue's base, and he's going to be moving over to hit Two Legit's main base. And we're pretty much not going to do much about that again, because RPG Marines fight Gauss pretty well. If you're a ones player on Perth or whatever, I know those ones players like to do that kind of stuff. But yeah, RPG Marines aren't too bad against Gauss. So fighting it's probably not our best option. I'm getting the engineer out. Their RB recall to play defense on my brutes. Harrinate doesn't really have much anymore. He's kind of out of the game because he has three supply pads and his haul rush is just over. And his base is unlocked, so he's not stacking anything right now. I'm going to upgrade a couple of pads just because I have the extra money. And I'm just chilling back here, trying to just kill some bases there. Avenue's base is dead and starting to move over to Tulogit's main. It looks like he's attempting to play defense on it a little bit, but it's not going so hot. So yeah, it looks like the engineer I built, I accidentally had on my teleporter still, so my engineer ported through, but now it's just going to heal my chieftain and maybe even my chopper. I probably should get inheritance at this point because I'm not getting pushed off anytime soon. But I'm just going to start double pumping Banshees in a second here. I could continue to build Brutes, but there's just no reason for me not to build Banshees when I have two summits. So that's what I'm going to do. I should probably be dropping that haul, but I don't think I do it for a while. So I'm pretty lazy about that this game. I definitely should have sold that for like a supply pad. I guess I could have built Jackals to try to help with the RPG hitting us, but that's really, I'm not going to do that. So that was pretty dumb. I am getting repeating cannon queued though, so that's pretty solid. And I'm just going to be chilling up here with my chieftain, slapping down some supply pads. Not too much going on. It looks like Harrinate is down hitting Two Legit's main with that big ball of Marines. And it's Legit has a fortress on that base, but they don't care. They're just going to strip a couple more pads and aim main on it. So I guess I'm flaring up there to tell the Two Legit he can take that base, and maybe he wants to take it. But yep, looks like he's yep. Okay, so we're gonna have a base up here that they probably don't know about, and that'll be pretty good. So legit, we'll still be on a double pump even when his main base dies. So we can keep getting numbers out. Looks like Harrinate is now building brew squads. He probably was doing it for a little bit now. Porting into his chieftain. And yeah, since I have this engineer out, I can just take a bunch of damage from the turrets that he's building with my chieftain and just heal my chieftain back up, which is kind of funny. I mean, for not even trying to kill or trying to pour the engineer through, I guess it's doing enough for me at this point. I had to build a second engineer though to heal my base. So yeah, I'm just going to try to camp these brute squads a little bit and try to do anything I can to help out just a little bit. And the double pump is still going. Still haven't sold my hull, but I'm finally like, this is a good time to do it. It looks like I'm just going to go for a shield because that RPG ball is starting to make its way up to the mid-tier bases. But I'm pretty sure Avenue also has a shield. Looks like he's raging a little bit. So they're going to be on their way to my main base, which does not have a shield. Harrinate does have 2 back turrets now, and I just have 8 repeating cannon banshees or so, and I'm just aiming main on this base, because since they don't have Gauss, they really have nothing to kill my banshees, because their RV also doesn't have any vampires. So there's the big marine ball. He was probably damn near full pop. He even took our base down. He took Avenue's expo that he killed. So he's probably throwing up more barracks on there and just going to try to pump more marines up a little closer to our bases. So I'm bringing everything back. We're bringing everything back between all of us. Legit's coming back with his hogs. I'm coming back with my banshees. I'm building an engineer. I'm building a turret because I just want to save my base. because that marine rush has been going on too damn long. And if it kills the third base, that's going to be a little ridiculous. So I'd rather that not happen. So they drop a cryo on my banshees because I wasn't moving because I was shooting marines. We have a Tech 2 Arby. I'm getting upgraded turrets to try to help deal with these marines. They drop a D-bomb. So that was so Loaded just spent about 1,050 on that cryo D-bomb, which is pretty costly. So he better kill this base if it's going to be worth it at all. And we pretty much got things on lockdown. There's their Arbiter right there, but I'm pretty sure that was, because Legit dropped a D-bomb earlier on the base of the bottom. Looks like we killed it at some point. Didn't catch it. Sorry.